It's a journey. Read, cling to the word. Whenever you are disturbed, take to the word. It is there the Lord will speak to you. Get back to your root. It is the root will sustain you. He is at work in you. That's why we read in the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 13, it is written, God is at work in you according to fulfill His purpose and His plan in you. So to fulfill His purpose and plan, God is actively working in you. So the enemy will come through various ways to separate you from the plan of God. When Monica went and told the priest called Ambrose, see, my husband is a drunkard. Not only drunkard, he comes and hits me, and I don't want him, that stupid fellow. I want to divorce him. Ambrose said, I will pray for you. Next day he said, God has placed him into your life. If this man would have married to somebody else, that lady would have lost him, left him long ago. But God has placed him into your hands that you may save the soul of this man. Now she used to search for him, because that fellow God has given to her, what to do? Where has he fallen? Where he has drunk? Used to bring him home, began to put oil for his feet, to the drunkard, to the head. He began to experience love. Many times people hurt because they don't experience love. And when he began to experience that love, one day he told her, by drinking, my liver is gone, my heart is gone, my intestine is gone, I am going to die. But I tell you, Monica, I would have died like a pig in the dirt. But today, I die like an angel at the lap of an angel. She said, I am done. The purpose of loving him, I have found the meaning. Soon she found her son is a drunkard. One headache is gone, another is gone. No, she never thought. Till the end of my breath, I am here, God has loved me. Until the end, I will give myself. Giving is my joy, because that's what I have received from my God. My God has given and given and given everything. And that is my ministry. When I get discouraged, I look unto the cross. It is the cross is my power. The cross is my strength. When I feel what? I have to work hard. I feel like this. I am not being understood. I am being hurt. I look at that. That's why St. Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 18, he says, the cross for many, it's a foolishness. Read that. 1:18. But for
surely, as God is faithful, our word to you has not been yes and no.
No, that is 2 Corinthians. Read 1 Corinthians. The meaning of the message
about the cross is foolishness.
The message about the cross is foolishness
to
those who are perishing.
But to us,
who are being saved,
it is the power of God
that helps me to overcome the enemy. Yes, the enemy comes and reminds me myself as a burden. Now the son is a drunk. The mother started to pray for him, started to kneel. At the age of 60, she was fasting and praying for the son, the drunkard. And one day, the son was bottle one hand and glass in the other hand. He was pouring to drink. He saw Jesus coming towards him. He left the bottle and the glass. He ran inside the house to find his mother is crying and praying. Kneeling and praying. 60-year-old lady is kneeling and stretched out the hands. He cried and cried. He got converted. He became a priest. He wrote a commentary on the Bible. He became a bishop. And he is Saint Augustine. One day, this Augustine, when he became the bishop, he got nice gold ring. So he came, he wanted to show to his mother, "Mummy, mummy, you know, I have got some nice gold ring. See, I got it." His mummy said, "Wait." She went inside and brought the ring which her husband gave. That lost all its shape because he kicked her so many times. The ring lost all its shape. Then she told him, "Son, if I have not saved this ring, you would not have got this ring." Yes. Live in love and give that love. That is the purpose of our life. It is for which God has called you and me. Many things will come and go. Don't get upset. People will hurt you. The world is selfish. And they will live in selfishness. And that will, through that, the enemy will attack you. Through your husband, through your wife, through your children, through your incidents, through your friends, through the money you have given, through various issues, the enemy will attack you. The first thing he will do is try to separate you from your husband, from your wife, from the persons concerned. He will kill the love. The love, we look at the cross, we understand it is in giving we receive. It is in forgiving we are forgiven. It is in dying we live. On the cross, we understand these three important principles. Lord, it is in forgiving we are forgiven. It is in giving we receive. It is in dying we live. Yes. And the enemy came into the life of Eve, separated her. Take decision for yourself. Don't consult your husband. And the marriage was broken. No. God came back. Put them back. He never thought, "You have hurt me." God is not bothered how much we hurt them. God is bothered how we can put his love. Till the end he loves us. He is not bothered how much we wound him. He is bothered that we are wounded. How can he heal our wounds? Let, as Colossians chapter 3 verse 5 says, let our minds be that of the mind of Christ. That we always, we don't focus on our wounds, but we focus on a child of God, as a servant of God, as the disciple of God. I am sent into the world to heal the broken world. So anything happens, I look unto the cross. It is there I find the meaning. I find the way. It is there I find the direction for my life to remain as a person of love, to remain as the person of fulfilling the purpose of God for which I am chosen, sent into the world. For this time, I am a vessel. I carry something for my time. God has sent me as a vessel to my time. I carry something of God which is needed for my time. This is the purpose. Close your eyes for a minute. The enemy is attacking you. The enemy came in the line of Cain and Abel. God accepted that offering of Abel. Cain could not tolerate that. God said to Cain, sin is sleeping at your door. Take care, my son. As much whether you love God or not, God loves you. But Cain was jealous of his brother and he murdered his brother. God loved the people of Sodom with riches, but they were trying to love in lust. Lust for man, woman for woman. And they were all burned to death. But God cried for them. God said to Abraham, that I cry for the people of Sodom. That's why God said, like the hen tries to gather its younger ones, how many times I tried to gather you? Remember, what are the ways through which Satan plays in your life and tries to destroy love from you? Check your life. How in the place of love he tries to bring lust into your life? When you are filled, you are full. And that's what God has done. But to make you empty is Satan. In the name of love, what are the things the enemy has brought into your life? In what are the moments you get discouraged? What are the tricks of the enemy into your family, into your life? Be aware of that and surrender to God. Invite that love. Lord, doesn't matter to me what the world does to me. Let me be your vessel of love. Let me be like you. Even if I am on the cross, let me remain a vessel of love till the end. Make me a vessel of your divine love. Teach me to pray every day, Father, forgive him, forgive her, forgive them, for they do not know what is love, what is goodness. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.